Alright, what's up guys? So today we're going to be doing an unboxing video, or actually a review. I recorded an unboxing video, but when I was editing it, I was just like, I wasn't really like crazy about that video. Like I didn't think it was going to be good. So I decided I'll just do a review instead of a boxing video, but I'll show you what's inside the box. So yeah, we have Shipair's package over here. I paid these with my own money. He doesn't know I'm making a review out of these. I've bought plenty of stuff from him in the past. I reviewed videos from him in the past in my previous channel, but it got removed. The presentation of these new boxes are so much better. I'm really satisfied on how these look like and how these spray like. It's just really crazy. So yeah, let's get on the video. First, we're gonna start with this one over here. I'm gonna go to the sample box after because I find that's the highlight of this video. Originally, I was gonna throw the box away, but I actually ended up keeping it. So this is the 50 ml version. It only comes in one version and it's a 1:4 ratio. So it's a cheaper one, less stronger one. So how we're gonna rate these is we're gonna just rate these on similarity. I will say my opinion, but it's just an opinion because I find clones are very subjective. So I'm gonna really just rate it on similarity since I went to Holt Renfrew here in Canada and I've tried all of the clones. Going to the Dior Sauvage Elixir, we have the Elixir over here. And this is Shipair's version. And honestly, this has been my daily wear. The reason why I like this more than Dior Sauvage, I have the sample over here, mainly because so many people have these, it's sold everywhere. But don't get me wrong, I still wear this a lot and I still get tons of compliments with this. So this one, similarity wise, I honestly give it a 10 out of 10. And projection, very, very similar. I've had people smell this after 5 hours. And then they would say, oh, you smell really good. What is it that you're wearing? And I would say, Dior Elixir. And yeah, really, really, really good. 10 out of 10 for this one. Highly recommend it. So now let's go on with the sample box. I do have a lot of his colognes and a lot of them do smell like retail. Like the one by Dolce & Gabbana, his inspo of it, his creation of it is really, really similar. Ultramail is very, very similar. Spice Bomb is very, very similar. And yeah, the ones here, you'll see. So when I open this, I kind of already spoiled it, but so when I open this, it comes in a nice presentation. I actually didn't expect this at all. I thought it was just a regular random sample box or just nothing too crazy, but wow, I am actually pleased with this. He changed his website, he changed his design, and so far, honestly, there's just no reason not to buy from him. It's just really good. The only reason I didn't like his stuff before is that the presentation was just really bad from his bottles. But now that he added like this thing here, it just feels very like high quality leather. It doesn't feel cheap at all. It might even be vegan leather, but it just feels very, very nice. It's hard to describe it, but once you get it and you feel it, you'll get what I mean. So let's go on the 10 colognes over here. So these are all, so these are all 5 ml glass bottles, and yeah, honestly, I already know for a fact that this is gonna last me a long time. I'm gonna try to spray at least once of these, at least once a day, and mix it up every single day, but it's really hard because there's a lot of colognes. So let's go with the first one over here. The first one we have, Leathery Path. So Leathery Path smells very, very similar to the Tom Ford colognes. To be honest, I really like them, but for some reason, like 80% or 90% of the girls that I ask how they think of leather colognes, they all hate it. They all do not like it. I don't know why. I feel like you really have to get that one type of girl that really likes leather. So it's kind of a hit or miss, but me personally, I really like this leather smell. I like spraying my room and just smelling it on a daily basis. I really like this leather smell, but if you're going on a date and stuff like that, it's very risky and I actually wouldn't recommend it to wear it on a date. Maybe on daily wear if you're going to work, it actually would work, but yeah, I feel like there's just better options out there if you're gonna spray a cologne to work. Safer and better colognes out there other than this, but personally, I really like it. I might just spray it at home on like leather couches or maybe a car with leather seats. I feel like that would work well. So that's Leathery Path. Let's go to the next one. So here we have Luxuria. So this is the clone from, I believe, yeah. So Luxurious, this is Ombre Nomad from Louis Vuitton. And honestly, this smells so similar. I tried retail and honestly, it's the same thing. So yeah, similarity wise, I give this a 10 out of 10. Longevity wise, I took a shower with this and the next day I still smelt it. So longevity wise, I give this a 10 out of 10 as well. I think it's just the tone or just the smell of it. Leather just sticks very, very long. And same thing with the Tom Ford one. Some girls just do not like this at all. This was actually the only cologne, and no, not this one, the retail one. I sprayed the retail one on me, and it was the only cologne that I wore in my life that a girl told me that she didn't like how I was smelling. I was so surprised. I was like, damn, it's that bad that you're telling me that I smell bad? So yeah, I was actually pretty confident with this because I love the smell on me, or just smelling this leather cologne. It smells like a Louis Vuitton store. And yeah, I was just surprised. A lot of girls don't like this. So anyways, this is Ombre Nomad by Louis Vuitton, inspired by Ombre Nomad Louis Vuitton. And it smells very similar to it. I highly recommend it because I personally like it. But for a date, same thing with a Tom Ford, I probably wouldn't wear this because it's not as safe. I would say only buy it if you have a girlfriend and you know, you go to Louis Vuitton, you ask her if she really likes it, and if she does, then go ahead and buy it. So this is more like a risky cologne and it's hard for me to recommend, but me personally, I do like it. So here we have Blue Chance by Bleu de Chanel. This is, what is it called again? So Blue Chance by Bleu from Bleu de Chanel. And honestly, I do not like this. I'll spray it right now. Yeah, personally, I do not like this. It smells too, I don't know, it just smells too fresh for me. But it is a blue cologne. This is more of a safer bet. This is the type of cologne you can wear to work. You can wear to just a regular day out, shopping or whatnot, just whatever, school, class, whatever. This is just a safe cologne. It's not gonna drive a girl crazy. That's why I know for sure. The problem with this is that I don't know if it's the EDT, EDP, or Parfum version, or I don't know which one version it is, but it's a safe cologne. I wasn't able to tell which one it is similarity wise. So this one, I'm actually just gonna have to put a question mark. All right, so here we have, I would say, I'm pretty sure this is his top selling cologne. This is Aventure from Creed Aventus. And honestly, this was my first cologne from him. I remember I bought, I think, an 80 ml or 130 ml from Chipier. This was my first one. And I really liked it. It was really good, but it was more like a day cologne, I find. I wouldn't really wear this to a date. Similarity to retail, the first spray you get is, I'm gonna spray right here. Yeah, so this first spray you get, I find it doesn't smell close to the retail version, but after 30 minutes when it dries down, then that's where it smells like retail. So for that, I'm gonna have to give it a 9 out of 10 on similarity. But other than that, it smells very, very good. It's just a regular cologne. Most girls will do like it. It's not a crazy cologne where girls will go crazy over you, but it's a good cologne nonetheless. This one, I would say it's more on the safer side, and I would highly recommend this. I would highly blind buy this, and it's just a popular cologne that Chipier has. So yeah, Creed Aventus, that is my rating. Longevity wise, I'd give it like, it's actually pretty good, but the thing is, yeah, I'd probably give this like an 8 out of 10. It lasts around maybe 5 to 6 hours, but I definitely have to keep a sample around me to wear it around, to respray some more during the day. So here we have Baccar, and honestly, this one is a very popular one, and it smells, I would say, not, actually, maybe I'm too generous with my ratings, but honestly, I give this a 10 out of 10 out of similarity. It smells very, very similar to retail. And yeah, honestly, the thing is with me, I don't like it personally, but I know girls that told me when I asked them what's their favorite cologne, and they told me this one specifically, Bacar. And I was just surprised, like, why is it so like narrowed down? Like, how did you even know that? I find this cologne is quite safe, but it's not a crowd pleaser. It's like it only impresses some people, and it's all right. I probably wouldn't recommend it, but it's all right. And I think this is why most of these colognes smell similar to retail, because this one is actually his top 10. I feel like one of the reasons why they're top 10 is because they do smell similar to retail. So this one, personal rating, I give this like a 7 out of 10 because I don't really like this cologne. But people pleaser wise, it's probably a 7 out of 10. Similarity wise, 10 out of 10. Longevity, about 5 to 6 hours. So yeah, it's not bad. If you like this cologne, smell retail. I would say smell retail, and if you like this cologne, then definitely buy it. So yeah, that's Bacar, inspired by Bacar Rouge. So next we have Hint Vanilla. And oh my God, so this is a Tom Ford dupe, or a Tom Ford inspo cologne. And wow, this one smells really, really good. This one is a 50-50 as well. It's either girls really love it or girls really hate it. So it's very, very, smells like vanilla. I'm actually gonna spray it on me right now. Yeah, honestly, it smells like white chocolate. Like, I don't know, it's not like, not even white chocolate, but it smells like vanilla. If you go to a store and you smell vanilla, it'd be like that. Similarity wise to retail, I give this a 10 out of 10 as well. It smells very similar. Longevity, I'd actually give this like a 9 out of 10. This would last around 8 hours. This lasts a long time. And yeah, like I said, is it a safe cologne? Not really. I would say more it's in the middle. People love it, people hate it. It's like two extremes. There's no middle with this one. So personally, me, I actually adore it, but it's a cologne that I can't wear all the time. So I'm glad having a 5 ml, because honestly, this 5 ml is probably gonna last me a long time. So next cologne. So next cologne, we have Vermos by Versace Eros. And honestly, this one, similarity wise, I don't know, it just doesn't smell different. It's kind of hard to describe it. It doesn't smell the same. It's just hard to describe it. I give this like a 9 out of 10. The reason why the rating is still so high is because I gave Versace Eros to my friend, the one from Chez Pierre. And he absolutely, like, he got so many compliments. It's his club fragrance. Every time he goes out, girls compliment him, saying that he smells really good. So this is definitely a safe buy cologne. Smells very similar to retail. I would say go to retail and smell Versace Eros. You probably already smelled it because of how popular this already is. And yeah, it's a safe cologne. You can actually wear this during the day and night. And yeah, personal rating, I give this a 7 out of 10. I'm not too crazy about it, but I'm sure a lot of people will really, really like this cologne. So yeah, that's my rating on these. Projection or like longevity, around like 8 out of 10, I would say, because it lasts about eight hours. It lasts a really long time. But yeah, it's a cologne that is just good for clubbing or a night out. So yeah, Versace Eros. I'm happy again having a 5 ml. I don't want any more than that. I barely spray Versace Eros anyways. So yeah, that's Versace Eros. Now we have Wild Bergamot. So this one, similarity wise, I'm gonna compare it to this is EDT. So it doesn't smell like EDT, in my opinion. It smells more like EDP. Similarity wise, I give this a 9 out of 10. But again, the reason why the rating is so high is because I've got tons and tons of compliments with this. There's days I spray Wild Bergamot and these, because I usually switch between Dior Sauvage Elixir and Wild Bergamot, or basically Dior Sauvage. And a lot of people will tell me like, oh wow, you smell really good today. And it was this one. I was spraying Dior Sauvage. And yeah, so really both of these are good. Highly, highly recommend both. And yeah, similarity, I would say it's more closer to the EDP version, not the EDT version that I have here. Me personally, I like the EDT version from retail. I find it's cheaper and it projects even longer. So yeah, longevity wise of the wild bergamot, I give this around like 8 out of 10. I find it's a bit less than retail, but it can easily be fixed if you get the 1-to-2 ratio, because I'm pretty sure retail, well, especially the EDT version, is 1-to-2, because Eau de Toilette is stronger. It has more, it's more concentrated in it, and EDP tends to be lighter. But yeah, this is all. But yeah, if you want it to be stronger, either get the higher ratio one or just bring a bottle with you. And me personally, again, I'm okay with the 5 ml. It's gonna last me a long time. So next cologne. So next cologne here, we have Old Tree. This is by Tom Ford, inspired by Oud Wood. This is actually a very popular cologne. I remember when I went to the Tom Ford house here in Holt Renfrew, I asked them, oh, what do you guys think? Like, what is your most bestsellers? And she actually told me Oud Wood was her bestseller. So I was actually kind of surprised, because when I smelled retail of this, I actually didn't like it at all, but it's kind of growing on me. So yeah, similarity wise, I give it a 9 out of 10. It doesn't smell like it right away, but the dry down smells very similar to it. Overall, I'm kind of in the fence on these. I'm like 50-50. It smells okay. It's not crazy for me. And yeah, I haven't sprayed this enough to get what other people's opinions are on these, on this cologne, but it's okay. I find it's probably a safe cologne. Kind of weird seeing that for Tom Ford, but it just doesn't get that much attention. It's all right, nothing crazy, but yeah, it's a good cologne. I think it's one of those colognes that it smells okay, and there's, for some people, it just stands out, but for me, it's just okay. Nothing crazy. So yeah, that's the Oud Wood. Let's go to the next one. Okay, so last one, we have Madame Feather. This is a girl cologne. I actually don't even know what it's supposed to be. So I'm actually gonna check right now. Okay, so this one's supposed to be Coco Mademoiselle by Chanel. So yeah, let's smell how it is. It's okay. Yeah, similarity to retail, I don't know, but yeah, it's actually not bad. I find it's more like a day cologne. It's not making me turn my head. It's like a fresh cologne. I'd be like, oh wow, you smell good, but it's not really gonna get a compliment out of me. So yeah, that's my rating on this. Nothing crazy. I'll just end it there, because I feel like most people watching this are not really girls. Anyways, yeah, also there's gonna be a Reddit post a link to my Reddit post that I'm gonna do a review on these, so you guys can check that out. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Nothing too crazy. And yeah, this video was still kind of long. Hopefully it helped people decide what cologne. And Shapir, if you're watching this, honestly, keep doing what you're doing. I'm actually really like happy with the presentation. I'm usually a person that doesn't really care about presentation, but wow, I'm actually very surprised. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Really good with this. I would say, Shapir, please, in the future, can we get a sample box where we can choose exactly 10 clones that we want, not ones that's pre-made. But overall, pretty happy with it. Nothing to, yeah, that's pretty much it. So if you guys enjoy this video, like I said, leave a like, and yeah, comment down below, and maybe I can try to do a giveaway with Shapir for you guys. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I'll catch you guys next time. Peace. Okay, so it comes with peanuts, these things. I'm pretty sure these are actually, like, you can actually eat these. I heard somewhere that you can actually eat these, but I wouldn't recommend it. So